register and create an account with GoDaddy. I have chosen drlalisahomeoclinic.com as the domain name for my website. I'll check whether it is available or not and purchase it. Once the order is confirmed through mail, log in to GoDaddy account. Then go to My Products. Now we are going to the second step. Web hosting in WordPress. Click on Setup next to Manage WordPress. Then click on Create Site. Then click Manual WordPress Setup. Create a WordPress account. WordPress is now installing and creating site. It takes 5 to 7 minutes. Click on Explore Dashboard. Set up and attach custom domain. Now WordPress is installing to our domain. Now our site is live. Copy and paste our address while our site is loading. Let's start the last step, that is designing website. Copy and paste website address on a new tab. Add /wp-admin. Now we can customize our site after giving admin username and password. Select theme. Here I have selected iXL theme. We can go to the dashboard and customize our site. We can add pages, change or upload new slides or images, edit contact, add plugins, links, etc. The website is ready. Visit www.drlalisahomeoclinic.com. Watch it. Thank you.
My Nirmaan project, which I did using Scratch programming. Scratch is a block-based visual programming language and website. I am using Scratch to make a space shooter game. Video games can help kids' brain development. Video games help children learn to make decisions, use strategies, anticipate consequences, and express their personalities. But too much of everything is harmful, and so is video games. But designing a game is different from playing it. Coding this game helped me design, problem solve, collaborate, and persevere to create the game I wanted to play. It was a fun experience and a unique way to use creativity along with computational skills.
The most interesting fact about this game is that I made it myself without any help. So let's play it without any delay. So as soon as you start, music starts. So you move like this and if you keep on pressing the accelerator, so your car or the bike keeps on pointing upwards. So to control that, you will have to apply brakes. And this is our score. And if you stay in the air, here is the air time. So whenever you stay in the air, your score increases by the number which it stays. So, and this is the fuel. And so if this fuel gets over, I will not be able to play anymore. And that's why in the middle I had put fuel. Did you saw that? It was a red color can. So that refills our fuel. Now if I don't refill my fuel, it will take some time to get over. Yeah, so as you can see, as soon as the fuel gets over, it is out of fuel. So now you might think that this is a bit boring because it only moves like this and we have to control our car. So if you want, you can change the map and the vehicle in which you are driving. So if you press B, bike comes
and the backdrop also changes. So this is a very nice game. I enjoyed playing it and this is a clone of Hill Climb Racing, a game's name it is. And I made it by a lot of hard work. It took me more than 10 days to make this. And so now I will show you the code which was required to make this. This is the code of the processor or who handles the game. So this a very very long code. And yeah, this is ground. And I promise you that I have not copied this from anywhere. All right, this is of tires and items, message and events are cars. You can see this and our body, our head. And so this is the code. I really enjoy playing this game.
Start by creating the video, but first we go to Google and then we type here cartoon. So there are two links here, the upper one and the lower one. So we should take the lower one as it is in purple color. The purple color link is perfect for your search. So we go for the lower one. And then the link opens. We are in the home page of Powtoon. This is a home page called Powtoon Workspace. There are many columns in here: home, template, import and create. So as you all know that I've told in the introduction that we are going to create a video. So we are going to create a video by selecting the horizontal signs. So the page will open. So there are the editing pages opens. So it takes little time. And then it will ask you all a question that which type of video you want to create. So it is here modern age, whiteboard, cartoon, infographic and real. We'll go for modern age. So this is our blank page or slide. So we are going to select a background. And then here is an option called My Media. So I am going to select a background of coronavirus as this is a perfect background. And now I am going to add a text. Instead of editing a text, I'll add a text here. So as you can see here. So there are many settings of the text. This is the font design. This is the number to reduce or plus. And this is the style, like how you want. This is the color, this is the effect. So I'm going to change the font design. So I can even search in here. So I've got this one. So I've chosen this one. And I'm going to select a color. So I'm taking white. Now I'm going to type here. How to stay safe during this pandemic. So as I've wrote this, I can place it and I can make it a bit long like this. So my first slide is ready. I'm going to add the second slide in which I will tell all the tips to stay safe. So I'm keeping the slide plain and I'm going to add text here and choose a color. So I will choose blue and I will add title like this. Red. LinkedIn. Social. This. So now we have forgot to keep the font design. So I will select this together and I will search for the ones which I did in the first line. So I choose this one and I make it a bit long as I did in the first line. We follow the same steps as we did in the first line. And now here I add the pictures. So I will tell you how to add pictures. So there are many columns here, scenes, background, text and all. So I'm going to go to images and upload an image. I'll go to upload and my desktop here opens. And I'm going to select one picture, which is the social distancing picture. So my picture has appeared on my screen. And my first slide is ready. Now I will save the changes in this slide. So I have repeated the steps as I did in the second slide. So I have repeated the steps in the next three slides. So now I am going to show you the preview of the whole video. So let's watch the video.
App Inventor, where you can make your own apps and publish them in Play Store and the App Store. I have built this app and this is the interface that you will be able to see on your mobile screen. Now these are the codes that I have used so that the app works perfectly. WhatsApp beaches are considered to be the cleanest beaches of the world. It is one of the most recognizable awards for clean, safe and environment friendly beaches. It is an indeed a proud honor for our country. I'm going to show you how my app works. You simply click on here. You can see the list of the 8 blue flag beaches. Now I'm going to click on this Gogla beach which is in view. Wow, look at this beautiful picture. And this is the information. Now I'm going to click on another beach. Like the Kappal beach which is in Kerala. Hope you visit some of the beaches in your life.
This is a project that can be used for science class to explain students about the sinking and floating behavior. As you can see here, the light things are floating and the heavy things are sinking. So now I am going to show you about how we are going to make this. First we are going to go to code.org, then we are going to go to sprites and make a new sprite from the sprite tab. Then after we have got all our four sprites, we will go to world tab and set the background to underwater. Next we will go to events and take when this sprite is clicked. After that we will go to behaviors and press sprite begins and take it in the workspace. After that we will go to behaviors and take move. We are going to take moving north for floating and moving south for sinking. After that we are going to take when up pressed this sprite stops everything, and when down pressed the heavy sprite should stop everything. Now I will show you the example. As you can see, keys and caches are floating because they are light objects, whereas airplane and the car are sinking as they are heavy objects. This is my Nirmaan.
How to make a simple quiz game in Python. The commands I use to make this quiz game are if
if, else, input, print, etc. This is the code which I used to make this game. Now let's run it. So it says, welcome to Maths Quiz. Here you can check your maths by solving this quiz. So my first question is, what is 5 into 6 plus 55 minus 5? So the answer is B, 80. Now second question is, tell the only even prime number. The answer is A, 2. So it says correct. The score increases as you see. Which is the least composite number? The answer is 4, but if I will give the wrong answer like 6, then it will say incorrect. The correct answer is 4. It will correct me and it will not increase the score or decrease it. It will remain, the score will remain on its position. Now, the next question is 7 into 8 into 2 plus 755 minus 200. The answer is A, 667. Says correct, the score becomes 3. The last question is, what is 7 into 9 into 5 into 2 plus 555 minus 145? The answer is B. So it says correct, the score is equals to 4. Your total score is 4. Well done. The process is on the screen, you can see. So print command, answer, input. So this is the process how to make the game. Answer, input, then the question, then if command, else command, score, etc. Then at the end we have to give the, it is similar to the questions like, if score is equals to 5, then your total score is well done. Your total score is 5, well done. So like this, many of them you can make, and like that you can make many questions as you can see. So as you see, this was a simple quiz game built in Python.
The game starts with a cat that has to cross the pipe without touching them. For flapping, we can use either space key or left click. If in case it touches the pipes, the game ends. If the score is 50, then you are the winner. Now I'm going to show you how to play the game. Now I'm going to show you the coding of this game. Hope you like this game.
First we have to click on create. I have selected the horizontal layout. Then it asks you to choose a look for your button, wherein I have selected the cartoon look. The create option present on the title bar enables us to see the timeline and make the necessary changes. Scenes, there are many options like scenes, background, text, characters, props, shapes, images, videos, sound and specials, which enabled me to make this presentation and edit it also. On double clicking it, a window appears where we can do the necessary changes in the text. We can save this video also. We can share the video on clicking the share, then copy it and paste it wherever you want. Now I will show you the whole video. Thank you.
where I will show you briefly how I made this game and the exciting result at the end.
As you can see, I am already in my Stats profile. I will create a new project for this game. When we start, we have the default sprite character. Since my game is on coronavirus and the virus, I will create new characters relevant to my game. To save time, I have already downloaded the images of the characters in the computer. As you can see, I am creating relevant characters in my project, starting with Doctor as Corona Warrior and then the COVID-19 virus. As you can see, I have made the doctor move around with his injection. The steps are displayed on my screen. Now, I will show the steps for the viruses and how they attack the doctor to infect him. The virus, I have created a new weapon as medicine, which will give doctors the firepower to shoot the virus. As you can see, now a corona warrior doctor is ready and fully equipped with the medicine.
I hope you enjoyed the video and appreciate the efforts of a corona warriors towards the society. Thank you.
COVID-19 app which gives important information about COVID-19 disease, and at the end there is a quiz to test users' understanding about COVID-19. Now I give details about designing of my app. I have created multiple screens such as page 1, page 2, page 3, thank you page, information on COVID-19, etc. I have put labels and buttons to make the app more interactive. To display text, I have used labels. Also, I have given previous and next button at the bottom of the screen so that user can easily navigate different screens. Now I'll give the details about coding in my app. I have used JavaScript language to code the app. Mainly I have used two blocks extensively to code my app. These blocks are as follows. On event. On event means when in English language. Second is the set screen. Set screen means you set a particular screen out of all the screens. This is the information related to COVID-19. Now it's quiz time. Thank you. By this, I conclude my project on COVID-19.
Today, I am going to talk about ambulance navigation app. Hope you are excited and me too. So let's get started and know about this app. This app will will help the ambulance to navigate to the destination selected. It will notify all the Android smartphones about its approach so that they could give away to the ambulance. To build this application, I have used horizontal and vertical arrangement layout, label, text box, checkbox, navigation, location sensor, notifier, and push notification extension. The navigation component requires API key, which we need to generate from Open Route Service. You need to create a project in Open Route Service, which will provide you the API key. Copy the API key and paste it here. On the click of Find Route button, the application will show the route to the destination. Now, we need to add a push notification so that on the change of the location, the application will update all the Android devices about the ambulance approach. To achieve this, we have to attach the push notification extension in the app inventor. Once this extension is attached to the app inventor, we need to create app ID with the help of Firebase and OneSignal. We need to create server key and server ID with the help of Firebase, and with the help of these keys we have to create app ID. Now I will go to blocks. Here I have written two procedures: direction from navigation and update destination, which will help in getting and updating the navigation for the ambulance. Location sensors, location changed event, helps to send the notification to all the Android devices about the approaching ambulance using push notification control. Thank you.
My game on Scratch, the rocking block. So, before starting about the code, I'll show you the game and play it. We use the arrow keys to move. And that's how we lose. Now I'll try and show you how to win. And the ones which are stuck at the top are the spies, the ones which direct our movement to these enemies. Okay, so this is the place where our score is counted. I'll explain more about them. See, this is our hero. And a shortcut to win the game easily and to learn about it a bit is to look at its map, which is here. See? This is the maze. When you begin the game, you are here. And going your way through the maze, avoiding the enemy, when you come here, and when you come here, you win the game. That's why it's called the win box. Yes. This is a dot. This dot is the basis of the game. It controls the whole game and the background. This, our ferocious zombie. It chases the player. This is the basic instructions of the game. This is the screen we see when we win our game. This is the main screen, the one we see when we start the game. Now, when we go on its code, we see means to come, when to come and when to not. This also tells it when to come and when to not. And similarly here also. Now to our zombies. This block tells it not to go through the green walls, which is the maze. This tells it to follow the player and so on. Now to our hero. This tells it where to move and where to not. This tells it to respond to the arrow keys, and this tells it not to go through the maze. So in a nutshell, this, and this is the code for our whole game. And I wanted to tell you all a story on what my game is basically based on. Yeah, it is based on a wonderful story, Alibaba and the 40 Thieves. So you see how Alibaba encountered the 40 Thieves. Here, our player alone encounters the 40 zombies. So, this is my game. Hope you like it. The Rocking Block.
Dreamcode.org. I've named it Play and Study app because you will enjoy playing the games as well as it will help you in studies. So let's go check it in detail. So, here it is, my Play and Study app. So when I click on run, it will take us to the main screen. And on the main screen, there will be two options, play and study. For example, if I take play, it will take us to the play screen. There we meet a slider, and then we can place any value of a slider, and according to that, it will give us a floral art. We can give any pattern that we want, but I have took this one. Then if I click another time run, I will go on study and it will take us to a text input. Let's start with the basics. I will give the number 3. I will click on generate table and it will calculate and show the table of 3. Here it is, the table of 3. If I go again, I will take a higher value number. So I will take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So I will click on generate table. It will calculate and here it is, the table of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I made this app using events and variables and I have made it in code.org appline.
I have shared a step-by-step process for developing this app.
The final product.
Once you install the bot, first it will come with a start button. Once you click on the start button, you will land up in security checking page. It will check correct user ID and password. Then the main menu system subject list will come. Select the subject and go to the study map, either PDF or YouTube channel.
Introduction. Rohan and Reema were playing in the garden. They were swinging on a seesaw.
If you can upload all your study material on this bot or record it in YouTube, you can avoid to carry physical copy of your book and at ease you can continue your studies at any place, anytime.
Today let us revise addition and see how to add.
I have made a car racing game on Scratch.
Now I will show you how my game works. Click on the green flag. It's showing that press space key to start the game. So I just press space key. You can see that the garage have been appeared. In the garage there is a Ferrari car. It's saying that press 1 to start the game. So I will just press 1. So the game has been appeared. So I will just press D and I will press my arrow key to move the car. So when I will touch the, so when my car touch another car or the ball, then it will indicate us you lose. The accessories of my game is the horn and the steering. So when I will press the arrow keys, the steering also moves, and when I will press the horn button, you can hear the horn sound. When you continuously play this game for 40 seconds without touching the obstacles, you can win the game. Oh no, I lose this game. Now I will show you all the codes. So this is the code of game begin. When space key pressed, forever high broadcast loading. When the green flag is clicked, forever show. Now I will show the coding of Ferrari. When one key pressed, forever high. When green flag is clicked, forever high. When I receive loading, forever show. Ferrari. When green flag is clicked, forever high. When one key pressed, forever high. When I receive loading, forever switch costume to costume 1, show. Now the second one is of the start game. It indicates us which car I have used and which key I have to press to start the game. Then the second one is of our car. It then comes of our street. This is where our car moves. Now I will show you all the accessories that I have kept in the game. So the first accessory is you win. So the human will be shown when after 40 seconds without touching the obstacles. You lose. The you lose will be shown when you hit a car with another car. Then it comes about the steering. And then finally about our horn. So when the horn is pressed, this sound will come.
This project is done with the help of the website powtool.com, where most of us are learning coding and animation.
Pollution has resulted in climate change, which has bad effects on all living beings.
When the technology is advanced, the pollution level is high. There are three major types of pollution: air pollution, land pollution, and water pollution. Effects of water, air, and land pollution. Water pollution. Many water bodies die due to the unhealthy and dirty water. global warming. Land pollution. It causes no growth of plants or any crops. When the pollution level is less, we can see greenery everywhere. So, everyone, keep our environment clean and healthy.
Voiceover and music from the sound icon, inserted text field wherever applicable, and inserted characters wherever necessary. Thank you.
MIT App Inventor. Visit the website and sign in. Choose a Google account. Then you will find this page. I will teach you how to make a social share app. Here you can see I have made it already. I will show you how. I have opened the app. Now you can see I have used vertical arrangement, text box, button and sharing. You all can find these things in user interface, layout and social. You can change the properties as per your own wish. Now let us move on to blocks part. Here you can see how is the blocks part done. Click on button 1 and choose the first option and drag and drop. Then click on sharing, then call share message. Then click on text box 1 and scroll down and you will find text box 1 text. Attach them all like this. Now our app thing is ready. You can build it and save APK to my computer through and send the APK to WhatsApp. Now I will show you how this app runs. Look, I have opened the social share app. I have already typed the message thank you in the text box. Now you can click on the button share. Here you will find all the apps you have logged in. Click on WhatsApp if you want. Then send the message whom you want. Now message has gone to the person you have sent. Now I will tell you what is the use of this app. This will help people when they are having an emergency and can't find any sharing app they have logged in. They can use this app. Thank you.
I have made an game in JavaScript with the help of code.org studio. So this is an interesting game called Flappy Bird. In this game there is a bird called Flappy and she need to cross the obstacle. And if she hits the obstacle, the game would be over. And if she crosses the obstacle, her score would be increased by 1. So let's see the code. So here I have to set speed normal and set gravity normal. Set a random gap between the obstacle. Set ground random. Set player random and set screen random. That means whenever we click on run, the background, the Flappy Bird would be random. So here I have to when click, flap a small amount. So whenever we click, the Flappy Bird will flap in a small amount. So when hit the ground, play wing sound. When Flappy Bird hits the obstacle, play crunch sound and the game would be over.
obstacle, play, point, sound, score a point. So let's run the game. Oh, the game is over. Let's run again. So here's my score as +1. So this game will help you to increase your concentration and your hand-eye coordination. Hope you enjoyed the game. Thank you.
Nirmaan project on scratch, that is to make a game. So let's start. So here we are on our working space on scratch. So here is my character and here is my ball. So here I'll take one flag is clear block and then go to looks. From here I'll take say hello for 2 seconds and I'll type let's collect some balls. So let's try it with. Yeah, it's working. So now I'll go to control and then take forever. And then I go to motion and take glide 1 second to random position. And then I'll choose mouse pointer in it. Let's try it once. Okay, now my character is following my mouse pointer. So now I'll go with ball. Now in ball, I will choose events and then take the when flag is clear block. Then I'll go to variables and make a variable and type score. So now I'll set my variable 0. Here I'll choose score and then we'll go forward. So here from control I'll take wait until and I'll place it over here. Then I'll take motion and then I'll go to sensing and then take touching mouse pointer. I'll place it here and then I'll put it here, that's sprite 1 because my character's name is sprite 1. So the next thing I will do is that I will go to sound and then take start sound pop. So then I'll take go to random position from motion. So here I'll take it and then I will go to variable and change my variable by 1. And then I'll choose score here and I want that my score changes by 3. So here I'll type 3. The next thing I'll do is that I'll try it. So now it's working. So this is done, but wait a minute. It is only happening once. So I think, yeah, we should go to control and then take forever and go and place it over here. So let's try it now. Okay, now it's working. So this is the time to choose a background for it. So I'll take a blue sky. So let's see the game in full screen. Yeah, I started it and as you can see, it's working properly. Okay.
I will take you on a journey of understanding the phenomenal power of dreaming big and achieving high.
For learning the basics of coding and to create small games. Now I will show you the game I have created and I will also explain it so that you can also learn. Let's start.
So friends, this is my game, Shoot the Zombies. This is the main menu which appears when we start the game. It has 2 buttons, Start and How to Play button. To see the instruction of the game, you need to click on the how to play button. To shoot the zombies, press space bar. To reload the gun, press R. To win the game, you need to kill 5 zombies. If zombies hit the hunter 3 times, you lose the game. Hit the enter key to go back to the main menu. Let's start the game. As you can see, zombies coming to eat the hunter. We need to kill him. There are 2 scores shown at the top, zombie kill and bullet, and 3 hearts or lifelines of hunter. Let's kill 5 zombies to win the game. Yay, I won the game. Let's play again. This time, let's not kill the zombie and see what happens. As you can see, the hearts are disappearing. Once all 3 hearts are gone, we lose the game. Oh no, I lost the game. Now let me show you how I've created this game. As you can see, these are the sprites used in the game. I have downloaded shooter, zombie and bullet sprites from the net and created other sprites. I have written scripts on these sprites to perform different actions needed for the game. For example, when we click the green flag to start the game, I have set the zombie kill and die to 0 and bullet to 6. And when start button is pressed, I have shown zombie kill and bullet score at the top. Similarly, when the number of bullets are less than 1, we need to reload the gun by pressing R.
Hope you like my shoot the zombie game and have learned how to create it.